Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss this question from Code Forces round 649, problem B, most socially distant subsequences. So you are given that given a permutation P of length n, find its subsequence S1 till SQ of length at least 2. So you are given a permutation in which all the numbers are distant, as you can see. There are no repeating numbers. Also, you want to find out the maximum possible value of this equation. So what do you have to see is, if this is a subsequence, if you have taken out subsequence from this P permutation, then if you find out the absolute difference of two consecutive numbers and add it for all the numbers in the subsequence, then it should be as big as possible, and the length of it should be at least 2, because you have to choose at least 2 elements. Also, if among all such subsequences, choose the one whose length k is as small as possible. So to understand this term, you can move down to the first example which I have told you. So there are three test cases. In the first test case, as you can see, there are three numbers and the possible subsequence you can choose is either 3-2, 3-1, 2-1 or 3-2-1. Okay. Now, because this is a subsequence, you have to find out the absolute difference of all the consecutive numbers. So for this the answer is 1, for this the answer is 2, this is 2, this you have to find the difference between this 2 and then this 2, so the total will be 2. So now, as you can see, the maximum is 2, for so you have to maximize this thing, so the maximum value is 2, you get this, but the answer will come out same for this and this, but as you can see, they have told that you have to find out the one whose length is as small as possible. So for this subsequence the length is 3, for this subsequence the length is 2. That's why you have to choose 2, because if this condition is not there, you can choose the whole subarray, the whole array, because this will maximize the product. Okay, but that is not the case, because if you take the whole thing, but some smaller subsequence can also find the same answer, but the length is smaller. So I hope you understand the question now. But this tells you the trick, that if you want to find out some other number, you want to subtract some useless number from the subarray. As you can see in this, if you remove 2, then also the difference will turn out to be 1 or 2. If you remove out 2 from this, which is 2 actually, as you can see in this example, there is no 2 between it, and in this 2 is between it, but the answer for both of them is 2 only, because the difference of this is 2. So which tells us we have to remove some elements by keeping the difference same. So as you can see, I have taken down this example, the second example. Now I'll tell you with one example. If let's assume there is one element, you can draw it. If there is one element which is 1, the length is 1, the next length is 3, the next length is 4, the next length is 2. To find the max, if you take the difference between these two and these two, the maximum difference will be between these two only, now, because this seems irrelevant. If you take this element or only these two elements, the difference will turn out to be same. If you take these two elements, if you take all these three elements, or if you just take these two elements, the difference will turn out to be same, because the difference between will be the max, the difference between the biggest one and the smallest one. So as you can see, to find out the difference, we will have to jump between the smallest, go to the largest, and then go to the smallest, then go to the largest, then go to the smallest. So we are talking about the local maximas and local minimas, but the starting point should be somewhere. So we have to take the first element and the last element. But do we always have to take the first and the last element? So let's assume we don't take the first element. The first element being a very large number and the second number is very small. The second is this. Then you can, because this element is smaller, this element is greater. We will always move in like valleys and peaks. So this is okay, But as you can see in this example, which I've drawn here, I will rub it out. If I do not take the first element, I take it from here, the difference will be smaller. That's why I have to take this element. Because taking this element will only increase our value. So what our simple logic will be now, we will always take the first and the last element, which will meet a condition that there should be at least two elements. And for the middle element, we will only took those elements which are the local maximas or minimas, which is for every element we will check both of its neighbors. If this element should be either greater than both of the elements or it should be lesser than both of the elements. So this is greater than this, this is greater than this. As you can see, this is greater than this and this is smaller than this. But this is not the maximum. But as you can see, this is get this in this case. For to be a maxima, both of the numbers should be smaller. But in this case, this is greater and this is smaller. So this is not a maxima. But in this case, as you can see, this is smaller. This is also smaller for this case. So this should be in the answer. So the answer for this is 1, 4 and 2. And this is the answer. So I'll take it down to the code now. So we have taken the input of n, all the numbers, take the input of all the numbers and the answer. So we will take the input of only the first element and the last element and also the peak elements or the local maxima and minima. If AI is greater than the left value and also greater than the right value, or AI is smaller than the left value or it is also smaller than the right value, then we will push back this ith index value in answer, and after that we will print the size of this answer vector and then iterate over all the answer values and print. So I hope you understand the logic as well as the code. If you still have any doubt, please mention now. Thank you for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one. Keep coding. Bye.